Dusty old work. Okay, so that piece of cherry. So, very, very briefly, or very crudely, this is our initial shaping coming on. Okay, so I'm starting to put the neck in for the bowl. I'm starting to cut in this part here. So I've got the foot here. So obviously I need to keep an eye on the handle, that I don't make it too small. So I need to keep an eye on that. It's going to be about here somewhere, where the hoof's going to join. Okay, so you can see where this part is. Sorry, do it so you can see in the camera. It's going to be about around there. Okay, so you can see I haven't got a lot more meat to play with there. So that's going to be the bit into shape. So this is what it's going to look like. Actually, might just make it slightly longer. Actually, it's a shame the portions aren't going to be. It might be this cherry's no good either. Might be, made it better get a big enough bowl out of the cherry. What else have I got in here? See, this is, I don't think it's going to be good. What's going to happen for me to get the handle on here? It means it's going to be a really fat handle and a straight spoon. I'm not going to get the contrast from the thickness of the handle to the flare of the spoon. So, this piece of cherry. Number two, not big enough. Antler hoofed, sorry, deer hoofed handled spoon, mark three. That's a shame, this is perfect. If I hadn't. Just wondering if I could do anything. What if I took the dew claws off? If I took the dew claws off this, I could get away with something then. Right, give me a couple of minutes. I'm going to remove the dew claws off this hoof and see then if I can get it to fit this handle, because this will be perfect. Right, I'll come back to you in a minute. Leave it with me, I'm gonna come back to you. Still thinking, so I'm reluctant to cut this up, because I think this spoon's turned out really well as it is. And I think finished, that would be just a really lovely spoon. Once it's sanded and oiled, these colours are gonna just zing. You know, the contrast can be fantastic, so. Okay, so the antler hoof, sorry, the deer hoof spoon, mark three. Okay, this is the third one. So this is a piece of yew. Now, it's a lovely wood to carve with. You get, again, you get the contrast in the grain. There's a thing about the wood being toxic and the berries being toxic, or the yew tree being toxic. Actually, the berries aren't, actually, it's the seeds, but I've used yew before, and basically this is going to be I'm going to soak this in so much linseed oil, and this is really seasoned, and it's not like I'm chewing on this, it's just going to be taking food off, and the oil should seal everything in, so I'm not too concerned about this. Okay, but basically what I've got now is, line them up, that's what I'm going to end up with. So the ant will be the end, and then once it's all stained and oiled up, now it's not the whole handle, because I didn't want to cut up a whole foot, and I didn't have a whole foot, but it was going to be still, you know, enough of a handle sticking out there, and the hooves will still be out the back. Okay, I could make it slightly shorter, which might be better if I make it slightly shorter. It might be, let's just have a look at the camera now. See, at the minute it's like that. I wonder if is that handle too long, is what I'm looking at. Okay. And I'm wondering if I was to shorten it slightly, to say there, is that more in proportion? No, I don't know, I think that looks alright like that. I think that looks alright. So basically what I've got to do now is, now comes the laborious part, I need to hand sand this, and get it all smooth and get all these belt marks out of it. Get it all smooth, and then I'm ready to start hollowing out the bowl, which will be by hand with a hook knife or spoon knife. So I need to do that. So I've got, probably hours of sanding, I guess, hand sandpaper. Start with a coarse, medium, and fine. Get it as smooth as I can, and then it's a case of drilling these. What I'm going to do is, because you've got the two bones here in the feet. Or the two marrows, I'm going to drill these marrows out, and I'll insert some screws in the end there, and then I'll drill the corresponding holes into here, glue it all. Bless me. I will drill it all and glue it, and we should be good to go. So I'll see you in however long it takes me to get this finished. See you soon. Dirty chops as well. Okay, so I've now sanded this. Okay, it's had coarse, medium, and fine. So I sanded all over. So now I need to. I'm tempted to wire this now, actually, but I've still got to carve the bowl out. But what I'm going to need to do is start drilling these holes for the hoof to land up in. And I have cut it down a little bit. Okay, so now that's my handle on my spoon. Try and hold it so you can see. So there's my spoon. Okay, so if my hand's on there like that, I can hold it. Normally that you'd hold a spoon, the hoof sticking at the end, so it's still a nice little feature. Do you see the carved bowl? Now this is going to be quite a deep bowl compared to what I would normally use for eating with. Normally I'm quite a bit more shallow than this. So it may be a case of I'll come back once I've carved this bowl, take a bit of time, but we'll play that one by ear. So. But you can see about the grain in you, it's a lovely, lovely grain. You see it running through there, look at that, and the shadows on it. So when this oils, this is just going to go bling, I'm sure it will. So I'm going to lose some of the heartwood out the centre here, but I'm hoping going to keep enough of the heartwood in there to get, so you'll still get the sap and the heartwood in there in the middle of the bowl. But we'll see when I carve it. So that's my next job. Okay, just to keep you updated, what I've done now is I'm gonna fix the feet to the spoon blank before I do any more, okay, because it's gonna give me a longer handle to carve with. So what I've done is I've screwed in two screws into each of the marrow parts of these of the hoof, with a bit of glue in the end as well, okay, so that's got them bound in. So what I need to do now is take the heads off these. So to do that, what I'm gonna use is one of these little mini grinders with a cutting disc on there, rather than trying to use a hacksaw on there, because I want to dislodge these, and I can cut through the pair of these, get them nice and straight, and I'll use them to then mark where I need to drill on here. And if I'm very careful, I'll get them in there and not split the wood on this. So that's what I'm up to. It's as easy as that. So, unwrap these, unwrap the feet. So now it's going to be a case of marking them. So they line up. Which actually might be easier said than done, actually, because I need to be inch perfect on this. Didn't think that very well, did I? Right, let's have a look what I'm going to be able to do. Let's see if I can use a pen. Well, I think I'm pretty accurate. I'm going to take a chance. I think I'm accurate. So now, to be honest, in my opinion, comes the hardest bit for me. It's going to be drilling these in dead straight. So